Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So our topic for today is ethics of research. Even though it is one of the first topics tackled in practical research one, it is also one of the most important lessons in research that we need to follow, obey, and apply. When we say ethics of research, research ethics are norms that enable the researchers to maintain their knowledge, honesty, and credibility in doing their research work. These are also values that can be used in doing research. This must be continued when a research is being evaluated at all means. Hindi lang siya continued but also considered. But yung sinasabi kong continued, this must be continued to be observed. Okay? So when we say ethics of research, okay, so these are, sabihin natin, behaviors, required values that are needed to be followed. Okay, first ethic is honesty and integrity. Okay, so we need to make sure that the data gathered must be valid and true. So kailangan totoo, authentic, hindi siya dinaya. Okay. Plagiarism is not allowed in writing a research paper. Why? Because plagiarism is considered cheating. And besides, nakakasira siya ng integrity ng bawat researcher. Then, the researchers must be true in terms of skill and ability in doing research papers. So, you have to be honest in doing your research papers in terms of property, in intellectual aspects, in terms of creating a content, lalo na sa review-related literature, hindi kayo pwede mag-copy-paste ng work ng iba. And hindi kayo pwede mangopya ng work ng iba. So, yun ang pinaka-importanting ethic that we need to follow, yung honesty and integrity. When we say objectivity, researchers must be fair in with all respondents. So, it means to say that researchers must not be biased, especially in interpreting the findings gathered, analyzing the data, and writing related research and literature and other parts of the research paper. So, that means to say that the comments must be neutral, especially when you're going to write the review of related literature and the findings. Avoid making subjective comments such as very good, beautiful, ugly, clean, and the other. And the like. When we say openness, researchers must be creative. They must be open-minded in terms of feedback, comments from the panelists and the other reviewers, especially when they are going to make the research paper. So, kagaya sa defense, di ba, ang mga panelists, nagko-comment sila pagdating sa mga paper. So, whatever suggestions and revisions na ipapagawa, we researchers must be open. And besides, making research is an art. So, dapat maging creative din ang mga researchers sa mga ideas nila. When we say responsibility, maraming aspects yan. Una, social. Bakit socially responsible dapat ang mga researchers? Okay, because researchers must be socially aware and concerned towards the society. So, ang goal kasi ng researchers is to give benefits sa society based sa research na nagawa nila. Okay. Another thing is publication responsibility. So, researchers must be responsible in publishing, presenting, and writing their research work. So it means to say that they are responsible in producing research for future researchers and promoting knowledge. And they are also responsible in complying research during the research subjects, lalo na sa thesis nung pag-college and masters and PhD. When we say confidential, researchers should observe their privacy and the respondent's privacy as well. So this means that the information, lalo na ang pangalan at age, this must not be disclosed. So it means to say, hindi mo pwede ilahad or hindi mo pwede sabihin ano mga pangalan at age at other information na may kinalaman sa privacy sa research findings pati sa other parts of the research paper. So, dapat, ano, dapat yung keyword lang ang pwede gamitin. For example, ang respondent ko ay nangangalang Erica. So, in this Erica, ang isusulat ay math teacher. So, keep in mind that the information must be well protected and safe. Okay, when we say respectfulness, nako, very mahalaga lang. Mahalaga yan, okay. So, hindi lang bilang isang professional, kundi bilang isang researcher. Researchers should respect their fellow researchers and colleagues together with the respondents. So, dapat respectful siya in all aspects. So, the researchers must respect the feelings and the decisions of the colleagues, researchers, and the respondents. So, in terms of intellectual property, they also should give proper acknowledgement and credits to the authors, especially whom they cited in doing research. Naku, mahalaga yan. So, researchers should cite sources correctly when doing the research paper, especially in review-related literature, to give respect to the authors of the sources they have used. So, very mahalaga ang respectfulness. Okay. And another thing is, researchers should be careful in choosing words when they are going to talk with the respondents. Another key factor ng respect yan. You cannot shout at the respondents. You cannot say anything negative with the respondents. You have to treat them professionally. Kahit sino, dapat maging professional tayo. And we need to dress smart. Okay, we need, kailangan tayo manamit ng maayos kung mag-gather tayo ng data. So, another act of respectfulness yan. When we say carefulness, nako, it is also known as prudence. Oh. So, this means to say that researchers must be very careful in choosing words when dealing with the respondents and writing the research papers. Another thing is they must be careful also in gathering the data and evaluating their work and making a research. So, in all aspects, dapat maging careful. So, dapat correct ang research design, correct din ang participants, correct din ang statement of the problem. Dapat bawat part ng research paper ay correct. That's why we need to be careful in observing the content. When we say anti-discrimination, researchers must accept all the respondents in different aspects like race, gender, religion, status of life. When we say legality, researchers must comply with the laws mandated by the government, such as data privacy, anti-plagiarism. Okay, so dapat marunong din tayo sumunod sa batas ng gobyerno, na, lalo na may kinalaman sa research. Okay. So, do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit my notification bell. And thank you and God bless and happy learning. Have fun.